How good is Ruby on Rails?
Ruby on Rails is good enough for Silicon Valley to make it their go-to solution for slapping together apps.
I don't know if it is that good, because Twitter and Groupon made headlines when they moved off Ruby on Rails.
Ruby on Rails is good for apps until they start having hundreds of thousands of users and millions of transactions. Then the performance drops off relative to Node.js.
Node.js is pretty powerful. Walmart.com switched to it.
Because Node.js is asynchronous, it can handle a lot more connections at the same time with fewer resources relative to Ruby on Rails.
So why use Ruby on Rails?
You can create an initial web app using cheap talent straight out of school and get decent performance until you get as big as Twitter did in the late 2000s.
It sounds like Ruby on Rails is what you use when something is small.
Twitter and Groupon only had to migrate off Ruby on Rails when they hit it big. If you have a mid-range app, Ruby is good enough to work.
And with the Rails framework, it works well.
Ruby on Rails also supports iterative development faster than something like Java, while the common framework makes it easier to outsource portions of the work.
I heard Ruby didn't do as well as Node.js because it doesn't have the built-in utility development.
That hasn't stopped PHP or Python app development, which have the same issue.
How does Ruby compare to Python or PHP?
Ruby on Rails has a modest advantage to Python in that there is a single, universal framework, Rails. That accelerates development because you know how to program all aspects of it while having a lot of freedom.
And less available in code modules to reuse.
It'll correct itself with time. And when Ruby figures out how to issue a new version without breaking the old code, Ruby will be great.